Cake Master stream. Today, we're going to be going over some of my armored fighting vehicles in general. Over here, got a nice infantry fighting vehicle. You can just sort of hop in. And you can pilot it from here. And just a small little crew compartment. This is basically designed to help crews fight in battle if they can't get the support of a more heavily armored thing. It's also got like a medium cargo container there. It's got some side paneling. It looks like some little exterior thing. It's got a nice looking front, some benches, windows, and a ladder on the side, which is supposed to be like a rack, I don't know. Survivability, it's kind of meh. I mean, it's all heavy armor construction, but still, it's only one layer in every single area. Contrary to this tank right here. This one is the most heavily armored one, because it's a tank dub. I can just move this over. Hold on, if I take a good shot. Held up surprisingly well. And the cockpit isn't really that well protected. So yeah, it can take some hits, but really not that many. You want this to be avoiding fire most of the time, because the helm is the first thing that goes, like, every single time. And then you've basically just got a small metal death box and need to evacuate immediately. Yeah, it just rips straight through. I mean, it does pretty good against rockets, like, if I grab another one over here. Oh, that. Like, it can take a pretty big beating when it comes to rockets. Like, see, it's not even. Oh. Yeah. But overall, crew survivability is pretty good as well. Maybe in a later edition, I could move some things around to get the helm farther back, because really it's in the danger zone. It's the first thing to go. Something I might need to work on. But again, where am I going to put it that's safe in the crew? Next up, we have sort of my artillery vehicle. I mean, this generally works better for the purpose, but this thing gets absolutely shredded. Like, one hit to the engine, it's gone. Basically, it's not a tank. It's more like an armored car with more armor than a normal armored car. Does that even make any sense? The one problem that I have with, or no, there's many problems, but the biggest problem is it really can't take a hit. The turret just got blown clean off. The infantry fighting vehicle could take more damage than it. And part of the problem is, in its internal design, it actually uses a hydrogen engine and hydrogen tanks, which, oh man, is really stupid on my part, and I should probably design a new light tank. However, I feel like the infantry fighting vehicle is just kind of better for the purpose. And this artillery vehicle can fill out the purpose just as well. Yeah. Oh, also, did I show that the doors on the infantry fighting vehicle actually close? They're supposed to close. What's it stuck on? You know what, I think I'm just gonna get rid of this thing right here. Yeah, that was the issue. Oh wait, no, I've locked myself out. Oh, that's another thing. Don't close doors when you're not inside. It won't end well for you. Next up, we have the main battle tank. The ironic thing is, it can take a hit to pretty much anywhere except for the front. like, hit it in the side, and it's absolutely fine and dandy, but hit it in the front turret, it's gone. It's out of there. You can actually take rockets really well, because it was sort of meant to be... I mean, it's also got a rocket launcher and a Gatling gun, which helps it deal with anything from infantry to small fighters. Oh! Yeah, would you look at that? It's fine. But yeah, take a hit right here. Fine and dandy. Just lost a wheel and that's it. Take it to the side of the turret. Eh, no biggie. But then take one right there. You're fine. Or that might have taken out the seat. Yeah, that's another thing. I might need to move the seat back. But the turret is still functional. Everything's still functional. One of my gripes is that all the custom turret controllers in the back here are exposed, so I might need to work on that in a later version. However, for now, it works in its purpose. Oh, wait, I was going to show you what happened when you hit the... Yeah, right there, that's its weak spot. See, that turret just flew off. It's pretty much sheer clean. There's a medium storage container in there, and when it blows up, the rest of it goes. Then we get to the truck. So the truck, it's basically just a solid platform, and you can put any range of weapons you want on it. I might need to move the wheels further back, because they're not very stable right now. They've got opening doors. Just hop on in reverse. Actually drive pretty well. This one's meant to be just like a light armored buggy. Sort of. Yeah, this is just meant to be like a sort of a standard thrower. It runs on a hydrogen engine in the front, which means any really... Yeah. Case in point. Can't really take a hit. Ooh, I forgot to show you how the tank actually drives. The tank actually drives really well. Let me just demonstrate with it. Okay. Okay, there we go. I mean, for all heavy armor, this is pretty good. It also handles slopes really well. It's got some gyros in there.
Don't look.
Oop! That's a bit above its capacity, but it still handles it. Some damage, like. Cause yeah, the wheels are well defended, and it can also go like this and still drive. Yeah, let me just reverse around and show how it handles slopes. Much faster than the player. If you're running from this, you better use your jetpack.
Gross, do you have missionaries Hawaii?
Alright, this will be a test of the friction. Nope, just handles it like a champ. Gravity can't stop this thing. Ooh, this might be an issue. Come on. Ah, that slips a little bit too much for it. I'm just going to demonstrate against the ore handling facility really quickly.
Don't look.
Just moving along. It also does really well against rockets, too. Yeah, I'm rambling a lot about this one. It's definitely my favorite. Are there any modern day tanks that go 25 meters a second? Isn't that like 75 miles per hour? I'll need to check more thunder. Yeah, this is. It still moves pretty slowly, like, it's better to have a gunship to draw on to move it around, but. It still functions. Oh, I forgot this model doesn't have an antenna. Yep. Honestly, like, I understand that there's not really too much of a use for, incoming. We're going to its side. Come on. Oh! What just happened? I turned a bit too sharply. That's the issue. Well, it doesn't really speak too well. Oh, it hit like a. What even happened there? One tank down, we need to call another. Let's see how accurate it is. I guess that kind of speaks to the accuracy of the tank. If I just add a beam on the blue. Alright, let's. Oh boy. Just moving along. what that actually hit? Hold on, what? Halt. Let's hit the glass. That actually worked, so I can just kind of sit out of range. Testament to how it can handle hills. Oh, avoid the tree. A tree is momentum's greatest adversary. Alright, we're under 600 meters. They should be able to hit us between the crest and over the hill. Oh! Halt! Halt! If you're like up here trying to defend against it, you'd have to be like... This is the state the tank is in, and it's still firing. Alright, I'm back. Oh. Is it going the whole time? Just goes in one end and out the other, eh? No? They're hitting. It's kind of crazy. But yeah, so they're just passing right through. Processing. Ayo, how it's floating. What was I doing again? I honestly can't tell. Yep, it's destroyed. So basically now I want to make, or you know what?